Hey, how you doing? Dirty Bag with you once again for another edition of Let's Play Stellaris with the Zero Mod. Glad to have you back as we try to conquer the galaxy as the Valiants. I still have no idea what we are. We just got like this big old long snout thing. Kind of like a Rodian from Star Wars. Anyway, let's take a look at the galaxy and see how we're stacking up here. So the map is starting to get unveiled. We do have some ancients to the stellar south of us. We do have a couple more little territories around here. Pretty much everybody is... well, most people are... Okay, so yes, we do have the ancients who are overwhelming. That's understandable. The Aqlar, they're starting to come down, I think, in terms of their strength. They're superior in everything, so we're going to try to catch up to them for sure. Camarians, they're starting to come down in strength. They're now equivalent. They have two planets to our... I don't know. I think we're up to about six or seven right now. There's us. There's these guys. And they are a legal entity, which is... I guess it's a new thing for the Zero Mod. So, yeah, they got like a little piece of space down here. We could invade them, I suppose, but I think that would kind of force war between this chunk of space and us, which I'm not ready to do quite yet. So we do have this energy credit deficit that's kind of been creeping up on us for the past little while, so we definitely have to address that. We do have some debris from taking out some space whales, so we should send our science ship to check that out. And okay, I think he has been sent to check that out. Looks like he's actually researching that right now. Okay, good for you, science ship. So yeah, that was our thing. We took out like that small group of space whales here. We need about 1600 fleet strength to attack the space whales that are in that system, so we'll definitely have to do that at some point. So we'll clear this. We are full up on influence. There's not much we can spend it on right now though, so we'll wait it out, and hopefully we'll eventually get to a point where we can do some deep mining. Increases minerals, reduces happiness. I'd rather have more energy right now, though. Of course, I'm not going to turn down minerals at this point in the game. So yeah, let's do deep mining. Happiness will go down, but this is kind of our capital world, so that shouldn't make too much of a difference. Generally, happiness on your capital worlds tend to be... Yeah, you get a 10% bonus anyway from that. Okay. So yeah, that should be fine. Let's upgrade this. So it looks like we are into like the second level of planetary administration buildings, which is good. So they have no food on that planet. That could be trouble at some point. Yeah, so we're going to let this guy come in. He's going to work these two tiles for now. That's going to let someone else come in. And yeah, again, I'm going to try to hold off on building unnecessary hydroponics farm because I'm definitely guilty of doing that. Okay, so we can increase our authority. Now, if we do that, that's going to cost us influence every month, but it will increase the amount of energy credits and minerals that we get. So I'm going to go for this. It takes 15 years. I was wondering about this, and I can't believe I haven't read it. So yeah, you hit increase authority. It doesn't go up right away. You do have to wait those 15 years. So that's why I couldn't figure things out. I was pressing that increase in authority thing. It's like, derp de derp, how come it doesn't go up? It does take a little bit of time for you to get your authority in place. So let's take a look at our authority. So we're moderates right now. So it's kind of the middle ground. There's no super benefit. You know, there's nothing bad happens from our authority. So we're going to go up to this level. Apparently revolutionary attraction goes up. That's kind of worrisome, actually. Separatist attraction goes down. Energy credits plus 8%, minerals plus 10. So yeah, that would be good for us. Aside from the revolutionaries, perhaps. Speaking of which, we do have some factions. The isolationists, they still gain and lose power all the time. The security party, they want us to be more militaristic, I think. I'm not sure how we could be more militaristic because we're already fanatics, so I don't know what the next level up from fanatic is. It's a kind of a scary thought, actually. So we're 46 out of 49 for fleet size right now, so let's pump out a couple more ships. course, the game is saving. We are playing on Iron Man, so it is saving every month. I've mentioned this before, if I had my time back, I wouldn't have enabled Iron Man mode for this playthrough. Because I don't go back to my save games anyway, so it's more of a bragging right than anything practical for us. Let's check out World Park Quad. They have two food right now, so yeah, they should be fine. We'll get you to come in here, actually. Viral Lance, we can upgrade our mine there. And how we do it for food here? Food is at 2. So that will go to 1 after this guy comes in. So we may have to build another hydroponics facility here. We should actually build on the tile where there actually is someone to work first, though. So power plant there. And a power plant there. Of course, power is kind of our Achilles heel right now. Viral Gand, it's our newest world. Doesn't have a governor. Why doesn't it have a governor? Are we maxed out for our leaders? Yes, we're actually over our leader limit right now. So, okay. Alright, so, Science Ship is still doing a bit of explosion. It's not exploding. I hope not. Exploration. I don't think we've found any worlds for us to colonize at this point, though. No. So, we do want you to check out that system and this system as well. There are a bunch of really, really tough alien enemies in that sector. It's like 6k fleets. We are not equipped to handle that right now, so we won't be heading into this sector anytime soon. There are 2 energy in the Zubin sector that we... Okay, so my construction ship will go there eventually. We do want you to build more mining stations, though. That not within our boundary? No, it's right at the edge. Living on the edge of the Shamrock City. Okay. Yeah, I don't think we can actually get him to do too much else. Alright. So yeah, so we do want to get this up to about 1600-1700 so we can take out these space whales. Haven't encountered the pop-up for piracy yet, so I don't know if you get that kind of same early game piracy thing that kind of forces you to build a fleet with this mod. And of course, there is a race of pirates that you can play, or you can make your own race of pirates. The vault is a tomb for hopeful immortals. Okay. Let's download their neural patterns. I think sometimes the ancients like it if you do that, so let's go for that. Mineral processing. We can build a mineral processing plant now. That's going to up our mineral outputs on certain planets. Fusion missiles, too. I'm trying to move away from the missile technology. What does this resource do? Explosion weapons. Okay. Everything's about explosives today. Yeah, let's go for an engineering facility so we can get to work on that. We're doing 26 for engineering right now. Seems like our research has taken us about a year per technology, so I guess that's not terrible. It's not the greatest, but it's not terrible either. And, we're sending, yes, okay, we are sending you back there as well. Again, we're using wormhole technology, so everyone has to kind of jump back to these hubs before they jump out anywhere else. I'll probably build another wormhole generator up in this direction, I suppose. Doesn't seem to be too much in this sector of space, so we're definitely going to need some new worlds to colonize fairly soon, so... We'll put that in the queue for our construction ship. Come up here, build yourself a wormhole station. Okay. All right, so things seem to be getting in hand now. We are dropping 47 energy a month, which is quite a lot, actually. And we don't have that capacity overload edict yet, which is kind of bad. We might have to do some trading. Nobody likes us, though. Except... They may trade? I don't know. Let's try it. See if we can offer them a trade deal. We will give you some minerals. Nope, minus 1,000. That's not going to happen. Yeah, well, you're ugly. So deal with it. You don't want to trade with us. Take my ball and go home. Recruitment of armies on Valgar has been complete. And of course, we are trying to... Make sure our planets are filled up with defensive armies, because that reduces the amount of rebellious elements, or at least it does in the base game, I believe. Naval capacity plus 10%, which is good. We can build some more ships now. Amoeba flagella, that's not really a great thing for us, at least until we get up to battleship level. Let's go for the removal of tile blockers. Do we have much in the way of tile blockers right now? We have volcanoes on that planet. Nothing there. Sinkholes there. No, they do have some mountains there. Volcanoes and desert. Research complete. There's a couple mountains. Not a lot, though. Research alternatives plus one. That's great for us. Survey speed goes up. Let's go for an upgrade to power plants, because we definitely need that right now, and we really gotta try to do a trade with someone, because next month we will be over capacity. So let's try the Chimerians. Let's offer them a trade deal. Let's make a deal! So we're gonna give you minerals. We want energy credits. Okay. Minus three. We'll give them a little bit of a benefit so they like us a little bit better. That will pretty much take out whatever we have for minerals, but we need to do it right now, I think, because if we don't and the month ends, then that's really going to put a big kink into our research, and it's not going to be the good kind of kink, it's going to be the bad kind of kink. So yeah, I'll leave it at that. So we're still waiting for Pop to come in there. Food's at two, which is terrific. So we, in fact, may need another. Yeah, there's not a lot for food on this planet, so we're probably actually going to need another hydroponics farm there. It's kind of boring to build it, but sometimes you got to do what you got to do. We're building a construction plant there. And I said I was going to leave that guy alone. What is this anyway? Mineral silo, so we can upgrade that. Yeah, food's at one. Yep, so I'm leaving him alone for now because I don't want to get rid of the food or the minerals. So we do have an anomaly. An ancient orbital shipyard. Let's take a look. It's in a book. It is Reading Rainbow. We're going to leave that guy alone for now, I think. How come we're not building a science lab here? I thought I put the order in for that, but I guess I didn't. I must have been distracted by something. Not sure what. So we're at 1,500 now for our attack swarm. We can build, what, five more corvettes? Oh, we're up to destroyers. So we should take a look at our ship designer then. Take a look at our destroyers. We'll change out the missiles for lasers. All that's standard. We can upgrade our sensors. And we want some deflectors. Let's see if we can go for all medium there and then fill up this. Not sure if this is going to work. Oh, no, we're at plus five. Cool. Okay, so that's our destroyer. Costs us 235 to build one. And now let's just double check our corvette. So we're at the first level of lasers. Automated shipyard. Well, conducting their survey of Avaconia 6A, the VECF Jean Inri detected the remains of an automated shipyard in orbit. Okay, so that's a special project for us to do. Is there anything we want to do with the ship? I don't think so. Okay. So what system was that? That was that system, I believe. Okay, so science ship. You're eventually going to want to come back here and do the research project. We have a research project here as well that we want to take care of at some point. So we're still doing minus 48 for energy a month. It's not good. It's not good at all. And there's not really too much I can do to combat our energy deficit right now, aside from doing more trades. Food's at two. I'm going to leave that for now. So I'm trying to move away from building a hydroponics facility, so I'm hoping we're going to get an upgrade to hydroponics so we can upgrade these instead of relying on this tile. I'm trying to be a little bit more smart about my planet management. Trying to be. I'm not always successful. Okay, so you're fine. We can upgrade our power plant net tile. Good. Okay. So, what do we want to do now? As much as it pains me, I think we gotta try to get our strength up. 235. We need level. Okay, so we gotta upgrade the spaceport first. Then we'll start building some destroyers. That should bring us up to about 1600 or 1700 for fleet size. Then we'll head to this system, take out the nasty space whales there, and hopefully, I don't know, maybe there's gonna be some sort of awesome energy producing sun that will bail us out of this energy crisis that we face right now. Minus 47, that is terrible. What are we spending it on? Monthly production sector income, station maintenance seems to be a big thing. Okay. So we can upgrade our engineering facilities, that's a good thing. Ion thrusters. I'll make our ships a bit faster. Mineral capacity and destroyer assembly yards. I think we gotta go for that. See if we can strengthen our resolve, girdle our loins. Okay. So the station maintenance? That for these stations? Can we build a solar panel network? Yes, we can. Just want to make sure all these stations have solar panel networks. They do. It's going to help us a little bit with energy. Okay, so we can upgrade our engineering facility. We're not going to upgrade this because it's actually a bio facility. Okay. Yeah, we can upgrade this engineering facility and this one. Seems like we're going to be a heavy engineering race, which I'm fine with. Why are you leaving? It's a perfectly good world. You don't need to leave. Okay, we're not going to upgrade that. We're going to upgrade our power plant, though. Roll GANs. Not too much else we can do with them for now. Okay, guys, have to try to do a trade again, which I'm not really happy about. Okay, these guys were up for last time. Offer a trade deal. We're going to give you minerals. And I hate doing this so early in the game, but. That, I mean, if we go over that, it's gonna be worse for us. Okay, so we'll offer that. Worst thing is, it's making them stronger. Okay. All right, but we'll do what we gotta do anyway. Minus 47. This planet, I just might start pumping out power plants. We gotta get that number straightened out at some point. Okay, so system survey complete. It's a research project there. 11 minerals down there. That's the thing, we have come into some mineral-rich systems, but we're not finding systems that are heavy in energy. So, so our spaceport's been upgraded? Okay, so we need another month to pass so we can start to build destroyers. So their ship size 2, so we can build 3.5. Or 3 of them and a corvette. 3 destroyers and a corvette, that's the much unseen sequel to Three Men and a Baby with Burt Reynolds. Actually, there was a sequel to Three Men and a Baby. I think it was Three Men and a Little Lady. 80s movies, there you go. Also, there was a whole bunch of I Was a Teenage, insert classic monster here. I Was a Teenage, was it Frankenstein? Or was it, it's like I Was a Teenage Zombie, I Was a Teenage Werewolf, I Was a Teenage, I don't know. There was a whole mashup of teenage angst and being like a classic movie monster back in the 80s. I remember watching these movies. I don't think any of them are considered classics that are researched in any film studies class at a post-secondary level or anything. But yeah, I think there was like a couple of them. Like I was a teen. I know I Was a Teenage Werewolf was one, I'm pretty sure. Maybe I'm just making all this up. And I think there was a teenage vampire one too. Again, this would have been like mid to late 80s, early 90s. I think it was kind of a spin-off from the success of Michael J. Fox's Teen Wolf success. And I don't know, maybe all these movies just exist in my head. I hope they don't. And we'll build the Corvette. Okay. So that's going to. Yeah, that should put us over 1600. And we should be able to take out the bad space whales here. I was a teenage Stellaris player. No. Okay, so this system is within our bounds now. I mean, that's the thing. If I get my minerals up far enough and we find a race that likes us, you know, we can do some nice trading for minerals for energy. So we have passed the that magic number now, so that means that our research is going to suck, and I think our happiness goes down as well on the. Maybe not. I don't know. We do have an election coming up. Do we have anyone that helps with energy costs? Happiness, minerals, influence, energy credits. Okay, we may need to support him. So that's a good thing that for us to spend our influence on. I know I tried to say, you know, we got to be democratic and let the people decide. Sometimes you got to do what's best for the people. The people don't know what they need. What the people need right now is energy credits. Because otherwise, we're going to get left behind in terms of technology, and we're going to get steamrolled. And nobody wants that to happen. I don't want it to happen. And I'm sure the citizens of Valgar don't want it to happen. So, you know, I'm trying to do what's best for everybody right now. Let's build a science lab there. New ruler. Okay, so who did we get? We got monthly influence and energy credits. Good. Good. That helps out a bit. It doesn't completely dig us out of the hole that I brought us in. And you notice that our attack swarm strength has gone down. That's because we can't afford shields. That's another reason why you don't want that number to drop too low. Okay. Do we have another planet that's pulling in a lot of minerals? Not really. Not really. Okay. As if we did, I'd enact another one of these deep mining edicts. Okay, the Arrasians. Greetings, Valians. We understand that your empire is coming into possession of a cache or a cache of data containing the brain scans of an extinct species taken from the very world they once inhabited. Even though your species is too primitive to utilize this data, we laud your efforts in preserving the last remnants of a once vibrant civilization. Okay, so they're doing that this species preserve thing. We've seen this before. We'll make a copy for you, and that will make them a little bit happier with us, which we want because we don't want them to get angry at us and then steamroll. I wouldn't like that to happen anyway. It would be a very short Let's Play series in that case. All right, so minus 38, so we are making strides. The Arrasian Ancients have opened their borders to us, so they like us a little bit more. Can we do a trade with you now? Would you be open to that? You know, I got some minerals. If you got the energy credits. Okay, maybe. And they have like 100% trade willingness, so that's good. Like, oh, so we do have a new anomaly. Okay, so that puts us back into. Well, we just bought ourselves 10 months, basically. Okay, so they accepted that trade deal. I don't mind trading with these guys because we know that they won't steamroll us, at least not until they awaken and try to reconquer the galaxy. So, we're at 1673 for our attack swarm. Pretty much 1700 once you include this little dude. So, let's see if we can take out these space whales finally. Hopefully, we can. Yes, we can! I believe in my fleet. I believe we can take out these space whales. Everything will be solar sailor. Okay, we've seen this before. Gives us a little bit of engineering research. We can soon move mountains. That's pretty cool. Is there a construction ship heading to this system? Nope. Like you said, if you know, even if we're doing poorly with energy credits, and if I get the mineral production up far enough, I mean, we can just do trades. Okay, so we can move mountains. Ship upgrade cost, minus 15. I think we need more leaders right now. We have a couple avenues of that. Leader capacity plus 2. Leader pool size. Both of these are pretty good. I'm going to go for the little bit cheaper one right now. All right, so 1.4k. Okay, they probably lost a few, because we did fight them once before. So they probably did lose like a little few baby space whales. I should probably be a little bit sad about that, but anyway. Are we not firing our lasers? No, we are firing. How are they shooting missiles? What kind of biology would allow a space whale? Well, I mean, what kind of biology would allow for space whales anyway? But what kind of biology would allow them to shoot missiles, really? And they have shields. They're listed as vessels. Yeah, they are actually vessels. Okay, so they're not space whales. Kind of ridiculous notion is that, Durndy. Not everything you encounter in space is space whales. It's a fairly large ship, though. 1.4 to 1.1. 1.3 to 850. Probably going to lose another destroyer. Is that right? We have 44 corvettes? Seems like a lot. We lost all our destroyers. Yeah, so that means we should probably build some more. See if we can make up the numbers a bit. Anyway. So 1.2 versus 400. And, okay, they have that single ship. There we go. All right, so we'll send our boys home to get retrofitted and repaired. And we want to make sure our science ship shows up here at some point for the debris. Hopefully it'll give us some awesome stuff. And we also want the science ship to survey the system. Hopefully we'll find lots of things that produce energy. Hopefully there's going to be a habitable world here as well. That would be terrific. Terrific! Okay. So let's check out our worlds. Okay, so we don't want to upgrade you, and we don't have the physics upgrade either, do we? No. So we're at 4 food right now. Okay. So this is why I didn't build a hydroponics facility here, because we do have enough food. So that will go down to 3. Yes. What do we need? We need energy. So we'll build a energy. That will suppress the food in that tile, but I'm fine with that. Okay, so it has food here. Food is at 2. So we're going to leave that guy alone for now. And we're going to build a science lab there. I think our science lab's probably not helping with the energy drain, but... Oh, we can move a mountain here. Just got to double check the other worlds just to make sure I didn't miss that anywhere else. Nope, okay. Okay, we don't want to upgrade that yet. Food's at 1. Okay, so food is at 1 here. What do we need to upgrade this? Do we need 10 pop? We do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We should just be able to squeak in 10 pop. So again, what's our big issue right now? It's energy. So, we're building a power plant. We gotta do it. And what did we just research? Okay, we can build power plant 3s, which is awesome, so we can now upgrade our power plants. Survey speed, upgrade, or better physics? We're gonna go for the better physics right now. Build a better future through physics, so again, we may have to do a trade with the Erasians. Are they actually growing? Seem to have more planets than I thought originally. Trade deal. They like us, at least. You know. And due to the fact that we saved that data from the ancient race, I mean, they're cool with that. They're like, hey, they're trying to preserve ancient data, so we like them. clear that, so they accepted that. So that bought us, let's see, 280, bought us like 30 months. Okay. And we are doing like 141 minerals a month, which is pretty good. Sign ship. All right, so let's check out these systems. And we now have a bunch of new worlds that we can, or new places that we can survey. I'm doing the manual survey thing for now because, if we do run into anomalies and stuff, I just want to make sure that we can go back and take care of those. Okay, so that should keep you busy for a while. Space station construction is complete. Okay, and we should be able to upgrade some power plants. Perfect. Upgrade all the things. Unfortunately, that made us run out of minerals, so we'll wait till the end of the month again and continue our upgrades. Three. Okay. I mean, we're already pretty energy heavy in terms of buildings, but we're producing 20 there. And that's without even any edicts to kind of boost that. Upgrade all the things. Can we do the second? No, can't do it. We're researching. Special project complete. Okay, so there's a bunch of science to be had in that system. Okay, so we want to upgrade that. Seriously, we can only do one of those upgrades a month? I thought we were doing a little bit better for minerals than that. That system's not within our boundary, is it? No. Darn it! Okay. So we'll wait again till the. Okay, so we can upgrade you. Alright, on to the next planet. So you're producing 7. This is a Batharian power plant, right? Oh, so that should be a nice upgrade for us, actually, if we upgrade this. And we do have an inactive building. Okay, we may have some people starving here. Yes. So you're gonna work there. There we go. And since that person did move, we gotta find out where they moved to. Make sure they're employed. They have something to do, at least. Okay, they must have moved here. Food's at 1 right now. Whoops. Surface. We do want to clear the mountain range. So food is at 1. Has this been upgraded yet? So we need 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I'm not going to build any more hydroponics facilities here, at least at the moment. Again, energy is the big thing. I don't really want to clear this mineral tile, at least not right at the moment. So we are going to get this guy to work at a basic power plant for now. Doing minus 30 a month, so we have basically a year left in our reserves. 47 out of 58 for the amount of ships. So we can build some more ships, but just want to go through and just make sure we don't. Yeah, we do have some more power plant upgrades we can do. Society. Okay, 28 now. So we'll clear that. Okay. And how's strength now? How's the relative strength? So we do have one group that's still superior to us. Fleet power is superior. Everything else is equivalent? Is that right? Okay, so we are getting up to their level. That's good. We have another power plant we can upgrade here. Good. Okay. They're producing 9 now. Max happiness is 60. Why is that? Probably due that to the habit of building. So until we can get like a frontier clinic or something like that, that's about all we can do for now for them. And okay, he's building power plant there. Archaeological project complete, so we've got another artifact, and we got a little bit of a boost to engineering research. So we're 16 months away from that. Okay, this is going to be good. Once we get a couple extra leaders, we will be able to install governors here. And that's it, actually. But with the governor, we should get a little bit of boost to production, I hope. I'll reduce construction time in block. Yeah, okay. So yeah, we're maxed out on influence again. That's fine. Hopefully we're gonna find some neat stuff up here. So we're surveying this system, I hope. He's doing this debris there first. Hopefully there's some good stuff there. Is this within our boundary? No, it's not claimed. I'm not building any of the mining facilities in this system because that will awaken some very nasty aliens, which I don't want to do right now. Physics lab. This is speeds up our wormhole travel. Let's go for lasers at this point. And okay, so we can have more leaders. Excellent. Do a monument to purity. That will increase happiness, I believe. Happiness plus 5. Naval capacity. Generative hulls will take us a long time. Well, this is just like a flat up habitability plus 5%. Let's go for that. We don't have to build anything. It just helps us out. I probably should have looked at that debris, but I didn't. I did not. And that was silly of me. Could have saw what. Okay, so we do have. Yeah, we should be able to recruit a new governor. Yes. Okay, how come you were available? Did we get like a free person? Who died? Is that the person that we just installed? Think it was. Don't know where he came from in the first place. Recruits. Okay, so yeah, let's go for. I like adaptability though. Means they level up faster. Let's go for you. Okay. Just want to make sure the rest of the worlds have a governor and our sector, right? So make sure our sectors. We have two sectors? Should be taxing these guys more. More taxes! Okay. Oh yeah, we have one there and one there. Okay. Cool. We do have quite a few minerals, but we are low on energy. In fact, we only have a month left, so I'm just gonna pause it. Talk to our friends here again. Hey, remember, we saved that extinct species, or so we saved their memories. So, you should be good for a trade, right? Maybe not. Doesn't look like they're so willing to trade now. Darn it. Maybe the Aklar for a trade deal. We will give you minerals if you give me energy credits. I need them to eventually come out and conquer you at some point. Did I say that out loud? Whoops. Okay. So that bought us a few years. And I just want to make sure. Okay. Can we. Okay, so we can do physics upgrades. So that means we can upgrade this building. Grade U, physics. Better living through physics. Okay, that's a society science lab, so we won't do anything with there yet. Valpa Quad, no for you. Volant, or Vorolant. What's the food at here? Yes, yeah, okay. We're gonna push it to 10 pop and then upgrade our
System survey completed.
planetary administration. That's the plan. And this planet, one food. So we gotta get up to 5. So that'll be zero food. They will push in an additional population, so okay. I won't build. Why didn't I build a power plant down here is the question. That was silly of me. Build a power plant there. Yes, the isolation movement is gaining popularity again. I don't know why, since we can't get any more isolated, as far as I know. How come we haven't surveyed that system? Science ship. She was the science ship. Come back down here to do that eventually. Where are you right now? Okay, you're starting to survey these worlds. Okay. I'll allow it for now. And hopefully we'll find some nice juicy planets to settle up here. Big old juicy 22 size Gaia worlds. Gale worlds. Think I've found one of those yet. Has Border Creep brought you to us yet? No. Okay. And we haven't claimed that. Cimmerians have closed their borders to us. We do have a new anomaly. Okay. Okay, we should. Mean, since we can afford it mineral-wise, we should build up our fleet. So that'll put us at 48, 50, 52, 54, 56, 58. There we go. That'll keep the shipyards busy for a while. And was there another ship upgrade I could do? Or like the chip or something like that? No. I guess we didn't take it. I think that technology came up to be researched, but I didn't take it. Extra three society in that system. Awesome. Not a place that we can settle though, which is disappointing. Governor's leveled up. Awesome. Influence is maxed out, which is okay. Mean, I could build. Here's the thing, when we lose our current president, this is going back down to three, and when our authority increases, that will go down to two. So I don't want to spend my influence willy-nilly if I don't have to. So we'll let this guy continue to. Oh, somebody died, our scientist. Okay, so we need someone who's good at physics. Recruit. You're good at field manipulation, which is physics-based. Okay, you're long-lived. You have a spark of genius. I like the idea of that. A mad genius. Oberlin. The Mad Genius Oberlin. Sounds like some sort of book that you'd be required to read in junior high. Okay. That power plant's almost online. So we can upgrade our ship shelter here. So food should be at zero right now, yes. So upgrading this will push this number up, so that'll give us one, and we can upgrade these two hydroponics facilities. I like it when a plan comes together. Okay, so zero food here. And we are at nine here, right? One, two, three, four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine. So this will be 10. So once this guy comes in, we'll be able to upgrade that. Again, what we need is energy. So let's go for a power plant. Everyone we build is an extra three. Mineral storage capacity goes up. That's good. Mineral storage. Do we actually need any more right now? Probably not. Defense station, I don't use them. Ship hull points plus 10 if for some reason that special resource falls within our boundaries. It really does. Mass drivers, eh. Armor? I guess we'll go for armor. Armor up. Still haven't found anything great. I want something great. Something that blows my mind. Some awesome planet for us. It's the rest of our research. 30 months for that. Steam. It's a 20% habitable world. That's 20. So that extra 5% is not going to help us out too much. Are they border seriously pushing in like that much on us? They must be building frontier outposts. Sigh. Okay. So they're still superior in fleet power and naval capacity. Because I had to trade with them, isn't it? Like, hey, free minerals. Sucks. Mandate unfulfilled. Well, he died. So we have another election. What's up with you? Naval capacity minus 20. No, thank you. Happiness plus 10. Minerals plus 10. Happiness plus 10. Mining station build costs. Okay. So who has the highest percentage? You do. Deck. Oh! Okay. Glorious battle. Well, so we have to set some demands here. So let's set our demands. We want to humiliate them. That's all I really want right now. Okay. All right, so I need to build all the ships. Build all the ships. I don't care if that drives us into poverty, just build all the ships right now. Okay. So we do need an election. He's a militarist. Okay. Let's support this guy. Okay. All right, we'll have to see what kind of. So we have defensive armies everywhere, right? Please tell me we have defensive armies everywhere. Planet summary. Armies. Yes. No. Whoops. Whoopsie. Okay. So we'll definitely want some more there. So yeah, this is going to be interesting. And what are they trying to get from us from this war? Negotiates humiliation, and they want us to cede four planets. Ouch! Orb one. Okay, so orb one makes everyone happier, increases our mineral output, which is something that we desperately need at this point. Okay. Okay. We build any more here? No. Okay. So it's a defensive war for us. Okay, so how do they stack up against us? Superior, superior. Shoot. 4.5K fleet. Okay. Do we have an admiral? Let's see if we can get a good admiral. Weapons range plus 10, combat speed plus 20. Leadership, you make things cheap. Let's go for you for now. Okay, so we'll clear this. Right. Going to get everybody to fall back to this system. Are we building any ships here? Do we even have a spaceport here? We don't. Which might be good. So they may start bump. Okay, so they have 36 destroyers? What? That's improbable. Okay, we want to upgrade our spaceport here. Blue lasers? Okay, that's going to help us. Colony development speed. Okay. Okay, so let's look at our ship designs. So this will help us a bit. We're at minus 5. Okay, so we need to upgrade this fusion reactor. Save that design. Okay, so that's our corvettes. Destroyers. Upgrade the blue lasers. As many as we can muster. Unfortunately, that's going to mean we have less shields. That's all I can do. That's all I can do. Okay, I live with that. Okay, so the first swarm. You guys need to go get upgraded. You're at 1800 right now. Hopefully that's going to push you over 4000. The civilians are doing some sort of crazy suicide run. I suppose if it delays these guys a bit, it helps. You build corvettes. Took us so long to get up to 1800. This is kind of bad. 1890. Have we started yet? Or they probably, okay, they're building a destroyer right now. So the upgrade should happen after that. So 19. And civilians are being destroyed. Holy crap! 50 minerals minus 20 energy. That's not good. Our scientists died. Everything's going to hell. That's what I get for playing on hard, I suppose. Okay, that was the scientist aboard our civilian craft. Assign leader. I guess we need. Okay, so you're long-lived. So you're going to be out in space doing stuff. Long-lived is probably good. Minus 8 for war score right now. Have the upgrades started yet? Vol Zadar. Where is Vol Zadar? Is it here? It's there, okay. So they're probably waiting for the minerals they need to start the upgrades. Yes, okay. So that means we can't build any more ships until we kind of hit whatever number we need to do these upgrades. It shouldn't be a lot. Starting to run out of energy credits as well. Somebody jumped in. That's okay, civilians. Okay. Do have every Corvette we build, it's an extra 30, so we only need to build I don't know, 100 of them. Okay, so they've started their invasion on a world where apparently there are no defensive armies. That's terrific. That's one of my sectors, isn't it? That war, okay. They're done. Okay. Well, alrighty then. Good job, guys. There goes our civilians, yes. And I foolishly spent minerals trying to build defensive armies. Are they jumping in here? If they are, that's bad for us. So we can't afford shields now. Things are going terribly. It's all going bad. Self-lead presence. Where? So they moved up to this system, our home planet. This system. All our scientists keep on, or governor died. Where? Here. All right, well, we'll stick in a governor anyway. Just want to double check to make sure that we do have defensive armies in place. Might need a general. How strong are our troops anyway? 1.57. Neo-concrete fortifications. Okay. Let's do those because why not? I've never actually built any of those things before. The Ufbolian Blessed Nation. Hey, it's Starfish. Star Starfish? Keep to yourselves. Star Starfish. And yeah. Can I get a general? No. No, we don't have any leaders capable. We don't have enough slots for extra leaders. Yeah, this is super bad. And not in the beloved late 2000s movie. Okay. I gotta unpause it. Yes, station under attack. I need to get shields back if I can. There go some more civilians. 28, 29. I gotta see if I can do a trade with someone just to get that number back up. Shooting off missiles. Okay. Okay. Would you guys mind trading again? We have some minerals. Would like some energy credits. No? Not worth it, hey? Not interested? Marion's maybe? Okay. No. Darn it. Yeah, I think this might be a loss for us. Like they're using missiles. Well, we'll send in our fleet anyway, such as it is. Yeah, they're getting pounded. I only had some energy credits for some shields. Unemployment, yes, because yes, our civilians are being destroyed. Things are not good in the Zero Mod right now. I don't think we've done any of our upgrades yet either. Maybe they'll be too busy with the bombardment to notice our ships coming up behind them? I don't know. Probably not. We have a lot of corvettes, a couple destroyers. It's probably not going to help us. Are the guys we just met? You. They're a fallen democracy. Please give us some energy credits so we can have shields. Okay, they went through with it. Unfortunately, we've already started the engagement. So we're going in with half shields. Oh boy. And they're coming in. We do have some ships with a. There's like a ship with blue lasers. That's it. So many destroyers. It's funny though, like late game, you're like, destroyers. So what? So what? 2K to their 4.5. Seriously, have they lost any ships yet? 1.9 to their 4.2. I mean, if they do have missile technology and they have to target a corvette at a time, I don't know. We're gonna weaken them anyway. It's 1.6. We're doing 163 minerals a month. Might retreat when we get down to 1,000. We can bloody them anyway in 3.5K. Kind of do a hit and run thing for a while, some guerrilla warfare. 1.1 to 3. If I could get them down to 3, that would be not terrific, but it wouldn't be as bad. Okay, we're gonna retreat here. We did lose a ship because of that. We're gonna lose that corvette, unfortunately. I won't lose my admiral, though, and he might go up a level, which might be good. Okay. That gave Valigar a little bit of breathing room. Okay, so let's look at our spaceport if we can build some more destroyers. Okay, they're building all corvettes there. We'll upgrade this spaceport. We need like a level 4 spaceport. Yeah, I wish my civilians would stop throwing themselves at them, because that's a bad thing for them to be doing. Okay, so yeah, you guys need to get healed and upgrade it, hopefully. Gonna be a bit of a war of attrition. Yes, yeah, we lost the civilians, I guess. What's really, really killing us though is the energy.
Station under attack.
The fact that we don't have shields. There's no worlds up here for us to colonize either. Right, we'll continue with the hit and run tactics, I suppose. Okay, so they're being refitted. They should be. Or they got to finish building before they do anything, don't they? I believe. 159 for our swarm? Are we second that much? Is it the fact that we're being repaired? Well, we're doing bad all around. Let's put it that way. Why is that down to 100? It was just like at 1,000. Research is done. We could add armor. We could upgrade armor. Okay, maybe we should do that. Research is going super slow for us, though. Okay, so you want you guys part of this fleet? We are using every mineral that we take in on ship repairs right now. Okay. That's like an allied fleet. Very small allied fleet, the Aklar Empire. Okay. We found the Banthurians. Interesting. So, what's on the go in this system now? 3.3K. And our civilians keep throwing themselves at this fleet. I don't know, maybe they'll make a difference at some point. Like Zap Brannigan and the Killbots. See if there's anything we can upgrade. Doesn't look like. Oh, we can upgrade this place. Probably want these guys repaired before we do anything else, though. 97.5. Eight. Mean, they haven't sent in any ground troops, so that's a bit of a blessing. But the fact that our attack number is so low is kind of disturbs me. Still at 98%. Right, so we should be able to build destroyers here. Once we get some minerals. 99. Still only at 179. We do need you guys to upgrade if we get the chance. They're up to 3.4K, so they are building more ships. They are continuing their bombardment. This number seems to continue to tick down. Shouldn't, though, if it takes them longer to invade me, you think that I'd get some sort of defensive bonus or something. I don't know. Well, we'll see if we can save up enough minerals to start our upgrades anyway. It's maybe the wrong way to go about it. We are still building some ships. Tell us we need 341. Okay. This should start, actually. Once they finish building that corvette, okay. All right. Starting to get back on track now, I think. Still minus 20 every month for energy credits. Okay. Situation log, yes, very good. What is that? That is a science ship. Two energy there. No worlds to, for for us to take, though. Minus 43% for war score. Okay, so we're going to start the upgrades. I mean, I could theoretically retake that world if I built enough assault armies. What do they have left on that planet? Surface stone. Where is that? They have a few garrisons, that's it.
Ships upgraded.
Okay, so that puts us up to 207. Okay. Alright, so let's see if we can do a trade again with the they're so cute. Okay. So minerals. I'm playing like a desperate game here now. So are you going to give me 200? It's better than a kick in the nuts anyway. Why is that only at 200? That doesn't make any sense. Okay. So 1.3, they have like 3.4 or 3.5 now? 3.4. Okay. So we do want to build as many destroyers as possible, basically. The Ricky Autocracy. Hello to you. Keep to yourselves. Okay, so spaceport. We need a level 3 spaceport, so we'll actually have to upgrade this. Or, no, we've upgraded this place. Okay. Okay, so we'll start building destroyers. See if we can get up to our limit again. We should be able to get up to about 3,000 in terms of fleet strength if we fill out our ranks. Wait another month. Yes, our civilians are being destroyed by the Aklar. I get it. I understand. It's going to put us at 4143. And we'll start building some extra corvettes. This is a hard way to fight a war. Of course, we'll be out of energy credits again very soon. Doing 160 per month. So it's basically a corvette a month. A fleet detect where? It's a small fleet there. Our attack swarm could theoretically take these guys out. Maybe we should try to do it before they join up. Oh, okay. Never mind. Guys, go back. Everybody, turn around. Go home. Okay, again, once we're ready to attack, we'll do another trade for energy credits. Oh, this is such a hard way to fight a war. Anyway. Yeah, you build a corvette. 42 out of 58. How's research? Jumping in. 7 months for that. Better armor. You build a corvette. 42, 43, 44, 45. Just throw ships at them. That's my strategy. Just throw ships at them. Oh, God. These guys are superior as well. Yeah, I feel really bad about trading minerals with them now. Feel really bad that our civilians keep throwing themselves at their fleets. Okay. They still at 3.4? 3.2? So they're making a dent! I don't know. Maybe the civilians will win it for us. Probably not. 85 minerals. Why was that up to 160? Don't know. Or was it the fact that we had energy? Anyway. Another month, we can build another Corvette. That'll be great.
Hostile fleet detected.
Where are they? Yeah, see, they do have ships going to join up with them. So I think what we have to do is grab these guys and get them to camp out in this sector for now. We're 233 for strength. All right. Camp out here. So we don't want them to get any stronger. They have 40, so they'll have 48 Corvettes. Oh my. Right, anyway. We'll go camp out in that sector, so that will hopefully deter them from sending any more reinforcements. Course, our civilians insist on throwing extra ships at them. I should save up for another destroyer, I suppose. Civilians under attack, yes, I get it. Oh, so much for saving up there. 39 and 48. And we have what? 6 and 33. Well, I mean, I could wait, try to build up some minerals, and then trade for some energy credits. Oh, this is such a hard way to fight a war. Okay. 80, okay. See if we can do some damage at least. Dude, what's your damage?
System survey complete.
Okay, we do have another Corvette coming in. Couple more Corvettes, actually. We're back down to zero minerals. Because, I don't know. Our allies insist on throwing ships at them. Well, that's 112. Those guys are going to do great. A single destroyer and three corvettes, along and with no shields as well. They're going to do awesome. They're the civilians. At least they're trying to defend themselves, I suppose. I'm just trying to get up to a point where I can trade the few minerals I have for some energy credits. Oh God. Oh, the humanity. It's not going to happen because they're going to lose another ship here. Okay, so downside of the Zero Mod, the civilian fleets. Can't like order them to What if I concede humiliation? Acceptance minus 91. That's not happening. I can't even get our minerals up to the point where I can trade for enough energy to have shields for a bit. So bad. It's so bad at this point. It's like watching the train wreck. Okay. Come on, 160, okay. You guys, would you be open for trade again? Because you guys give like fair trades at least when you decide to do it. No. Darn it! Okay, what about the starfish trade deal? Give you whatever minerals we have. And I need like as many energy credits I can squeeze out of you. squeeze out of your cute little starfish faces. Okay, we'll send our attack swarm in. Hopefully we'll reach them before we run out of energy. Oh, this is so bad. Okay. We have 47 ships to their basically 100. Okay. Slowing, guys. Wait till you have shields, at least. There we go. So 1.6. So we're only about half their strength. Less than half their strength, actually. What's their admiral like? They don't have an admiral. Yeah, that might be good for us. And they may have some damaged ships from previous engagements where all our guys should be kind of topped out. Hopefully. Are they still superior with everything? Aklar? Probably. Technology is equivalent. 3.4 to 1.6. 3.3 to 1.5. Are we not getting through their shields at all? 1.4 to 3.2. Weapons damage plus 10. 1.2 to 3.2, so they're about 2k over me in terms of strength. Oh, we do have some civilians going doing the old, I am helping, I am helping. Alright. Build some more corvettes. Because I will retreat again. See if we can take them down to 2 point something before I do. It's probably a fool's errand. Yeah. Alright, get the hell out of Dodge. So they're down to 3k. They started off with 6, so we are we're whittling them down. Hopefully they're not doing too much in terms of building replacement ships. Oh boy. Yeah, our authority has gone up, which is actually puts us in the green for energy. Okay. We might be able to do something. Good lord. Oh, no, we're back at minus 7. Okay. Part of that was the fact that our attack swarm was lost in space. Okay, you guys go and try to get yourself repaired. We need to build destroyers, basically. That's Alright, these guys are coming in. I almost feel like I should try to spend as many minerals as I can before they get themselves blown up. You're not helping, civilians. You're not helping in the slightest. Research done. Habitability plus 5%. Okay. Monthly influence. Let's go for that. They're shooting missiles? Why are they shooting missiles? Anyway. Maybe they can whittle them down to like 2.9. So we're 5, 138 for fleet strength. Okay. Why are we not getting ourselves repaired here? Okay. Just gotta see if there's anything else I can do for extra energy. I don't think so. Oh, we can upgrade you. If we ever get the minerals. That may not happen. Of course, our minerals did go up for a little bit. All these jokers started bombarding us again. They're at 89.9. We have 25 ships to their, like, 80. It's not good. Not good at all. Minus 63% for war score. And, do they have any damaged ships? They do have a couple, but not much. And of course, our minerals for the next while will be spent on repairs. Okay. Doing 0.2%. I don't know, maybe I should like take off the shields and load my guys down with armor. That's all I can figure. How do missiles do against armor? They have level 4 missiles? What? Small quantum missile. How did they get the level 4 missiles already? Oh, there goes a single corvette, sacrificing himself on the altar of my enemies. You're not helping! Opposite of helping, guys. Ooh, okay, we can upgrade that and this. We can build a power plant here. Should probably have been paying a little bit more attention to some of my planets. What do these guys have? Level 1 missiles. We're not doing good. It's fine. Okay, I think I'm going to wrap things up here for now because this episode has been running a bit long because I've been kind of fascinated by the position that I've put myself in. Anyway, hey, if you liked what you saw here, think about liking the video and think about subscribing to the channel. We'll see you next time as we try to dig ourselves out of this hole that we currently find ourselves in. Take care. Have a great day.